Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Foreign Correspondents Club of Japan. My name is Martin Koenig, and I'm the moderator of today. Our guest, before I introduce our guest, I would like to introduce our translator of today, Takamatsu-san. And I will make my introduction very short because we don't have much time. Our guest is Professor Yotaro Hatamura, the chairman of the investigation committee on the accident at Fukushima nuclear power stations of Tokyo Electric Power Company of the Japanese government. When he started his job, he said he wishes that the findings of the report can last a century. And now he will tell us whether he could fulfill his promise. Please give our guest a very warm welcome. And I will hand over the floor to you. Thank you very much.
It's not good to speak in English today. I'm going to speak in Japanese today, excuse me.
Fukushima 原発の事故調査検証委員会の委員長をやっております畑村陽太郎です。今日は私たちがやった最終報告の説明をここでやらせていただくのをとてもありがたいことだというふうに思っています。
As was introduced, I am Yotaro Hatamura, and I am the head of this government panel investigating the Fukushima nuclear accident. It is a great opportunity, and we are very, very grateful for the opportunity to have this chance to explain the final report to you.
最終報告は500ページ弱の厚さで、ページ数の本文と、それから300ページ弱の資料編から出来上がっていて、全部の厚さをやるとこんな厚さになってしまいます。
Some of you may be aware of this, but the final report is very, very long. It's a little less than 500 pages. In addition, there are reference documents as well, and they are about 300 pages in total. So if you add all of them up together, it represents a report in documents about this thick.
これも英語に翻訳する作業を今やっているところですので、9月の中頃か末頃までにはこの熱いものが英語で読めるようになります。今作業をやっているところです。
We're frantically working to translate this document into English now. Probably sometime in mid-September or late September, we should be able to read the entire huge document in English.
それで、本文の中にどんなことが分かったか、それからどんなことを考えたか、何を提言するかということが書いてあります。そしてそれのサマリーは皆さんのところに今日配られているんじゃないかと思いますが、配られているかな、それは配られてないですか。
No, excuse me. The actual report, if you read it, it explains what we learned through this process, what we were thinking as we were preparing the report, and what recommendations we had decided to make. There was, however, although the main report is not being translated, we did have a summary in English that was very, very short, which the interpreter printed off the homepage. Unfortunately, it has not yet been distributed to you, perhaps so we can download it and distribute copies to you right away.
そしてそれに、そこにも本文の後ろに載っていますが、あれにも載っていない中身で、私がこの中、これだけの調査をやって、一体最後にどういうことが知識として出来上がったかということについて、今からお話ししようと思います。
In the abstract that is now being downloaded and printed out for you, this simply represents a summary of our findings from the main report. In the Japanese version, there's also a section where I, as chairman, basically talk about the things that I learned as a result of this process. This is not included in the English summary that will be distributed to you later, so I'd like to briefly go over these points now.
まず一番初めに事故はどんなものだったかというのを一番簡単に言うと、地震によって電源がなくなった。しかし津波によって配電盤の機能がなくなりました。
The first thing I'd like to say is that when we look back on this accident, what exactly happened? The first thing, to describe the accident in very simple terms, there was an earthquake, and as a result, power was lost. What happened afterwards was that as a result of the tsunami, the electrical distribution panel was also destroyed.
で、結局、原子炉が冷却不能になったということです。
As a result, the reactor could no longer be cooled.
それからそれでいて今の状態でなんとか収まっているというのは最悪の事態を阻止する現場で働いていた人たちが献身的な働きをしたのでここで収まっています。
And the further conclusion I would like to make is that even in spite of these terrible circumstances, the fact that this accident did not escalate into an even worse situation, this was due, in other words, a more horrible situation was averted because of the tremendous dedication and earnest work, sincere work of the people on site.
そして今回の事故の事故を全体として見たときに一番大事な部分は発電所の中で起こった事柄に関心が集まりすぎますが、それよりは放射性物質の放散のために周辺の住民が、無理やりですね、それまでの生活していた場所から引き剥がされてしまったということです。
The other thing that I would like to point out is that when we look at this accident, comprehensively, overall, the most important thing is not what happened in the nuclear power plant itself. I believe that there is too much attention focused on what happened within the reactors, etc. What is more important, or equally important from my point of view, is that because radioactive materials were emitted or released into the air, many, many people, residents around this area, were forced to leave their homes, their places of work.
突然に自分たちの場所から引き剥がされて現在も帰れないでいる人の人数は16万人を超えています。
Some over 160,000 people have basically been stripped from their homes, their places of work, and are still unable to return to their normal lives.
外部要因によるシビアアクシデントの想定不足。
There are other problems that come to light. For example, there was not enough advance preparation made or estimates made of the possibility that external factors could cause a severe accident at the plant.
地震については考えていたのに、津波についてはほとんど考えていなかったというのが実態です。
Some very clear facts have emerged. One is that the people involved in the nuclear power plants thought a great deal about the possibility of earthquakes. However, there was almost no thought given to the potential risk of a tsunami occurring.
日本は高度成長期に品質のいいものを作ることで日本の力をうんと大きくしました。
When we look back, we see that Japan, during its period of high economic growth, basically developed many, many high-quality industrial products. It was through these efforts that Japan was able to increase its economic might.
電気についても同じことを考え、日本では長時間の全電源喪失は起こり得ないと考えるようになりました。
Along these same lines, the supply of electricity in Japan was a very high quality and extremely stable. As a result, over the years, there developed a way of thinking in Japan that a complete and total long-term power outage situation was simply not ever going to happen.
そして全くそのための準備がない状態で津波に襲われて、最も恐ろしいことが起こってしまったわけです。
It was against this background, in other words, a background where there was absolutely no preparation or a very little preparation given to the possibility of a power outage happening that the tsunami struck. And as a result, the worst possible scenario unfolded.
日本では原子力は危ないものだということができませんでした。
In Japan, it was not possible to ever state that nuclear energy could be a potentially dangerous thing.
危ないものならいらないというふうにみんなが考えてしまうからです。
The reason for this is that if you ever admitted that nuclear energy is potentially dangerous, could be potentially dangerous, then the reaction of the Japanese public would be, we don't want it, we don't need it.
そして本当に危ないものを使わざるを得ないと思って使おうとする人たちは、原子力は危なくない。逆のことを言うと、原子力は安全ですという、そういう主張をして、安全神話というものを作っていきました。
In spite of this, however, there were people who had basically no other choice but to eventually use nuclear energy. And so the people involved in using or operating nuclear energy over time had to develop this mindset where they basically would not admit nuclear energy was dangerous. In other words, they began to say the opposite, that nuclear energy was actually safe. This was the beginning of what we call, referred to as the safety myth surrounding nuclear energy.
そして安全神話というものをだんだんと作り上げていくうちに、最も危ないことを考えることをやめてしまったというふうに見えます。
When I look at the situation, I see that over the years, as more and more people believed even strongly, more strongly in this safety myth, there began to develop over time this understanding that people really never thought about really.People simply stopped thinking about the possible dangers of nuclear energy.
また完全なものしか自分たちは提供してはいけないというふうに思っているうちに、放射性物質がもしも外に出たときにはこういうふうに流れるぞという、そういうことを予測するシステム、それがスピーディーというものですが、このスピーディーの放射、必要な入力がなかったら、もうこのシステムは使えないものだと勝手に決めてしまって、避難する人に情報を伝える努力を全くやりませんでした。
Over time, people began to develop this idea that it was very, very nuclear energy was safe. Not only that, over time, people involved in nuclear energy began to develop this mindset that they could only present to the public things that were complete and 100% safe. As a result, although there was this system that was put into place called the Speedy system, which in case of some kind of an accident could predict where radioactive materials might be emitted. In spite of the fact that there was this system, because there was this mindset that one could not give any kind of information or give anything to the public that was not complete, entire, 100%. Because when the accident occurred, there was some data that was missing from the Speedy system. The people who could have given out even partial information coming from Speedy, because the information was not complete, they refrained from giving it out. What this meant was that residents who might have been able to use even that partial information from Speedy were not able to use that information.
放射性物質が外に撒き散らされて、みんなが逃げなければいけないときに、実は風の向きと地形の情報だけで、十分にどこにどんなふうに放射性物質が降りてくるかは計算ができていました。しかしそれを避難する人たちには全く伝えられませんでした。
Although all of the data that needed to be put into the Speedy system was not able to be put in, still there was much data that could be given from the Speedy system to the people. In other words, Speedy had inside its calculations the lay of the land, the topography of the land. It could also take weather data and predict which way the wind was blowing. Even though it did not have detailed information about how much radioactive materials were actually emitted, it could still give people who were fleeing desperately from their homes to safety, it could have given some...people an idea of which areas to avoid, which areas to flee to, but this information was not given to them.
仮にそれが避難する人たちに 正しく伝えられていたとしたら、避難する人たちは自分で避難の方向を選ぶことができて、今のようなひどい不信感の塊になることはなかったというふうに思います。
I feel very strongly that even if that information was incomplete, if that information about general wind direction, general topography could have been given to the people who were fleeing, then a lot of them could at least have made their own decisions as to which direction in which they might want to evacuate. And also, if that information had been given, the kind of deep distrust of the government of TEPCO that we see here now could in many ways have been avoided.
こうしてみると今回の事故の真の原因は次のいくつかになると思います。
As a result, I believe that when we try to look for the fundamental true reasons behind this accident, I think they can be summarized as follows.
外的要因としての津波を想定しなかったこと。
One is that, as I mentioned earlier, there was not enough expectations or presumptions or imagination given to the possibility that a huge tsunami could come. In other words, an external force could come.
次に、全電源喪失を想定した対策が全く行われていなかったこと。
Also, there were no countermeasures put into place for the possibility of a complete power outage.
最悪の事態を想定してそれに準備するということが行われていなかったこと。
There were also no preparations made for a worst case scenario.
このような想定外事象に対応できる個人を作る教育や文化がなかったこと。
And in regard to being able to imagine a worst possible situation, and in regard to having people who can respond to very, very unexpected circumstances, there was not enough education and training given to develop this kind of manpower, people who could think for themselves in this regard.
この事故で学んだことを100年後にもきちんと理解してもらうには、今ここで起こったことから最後にどんな知識を得たかを言葉にする必要があると思っています。
As was mentioned earlier, we believe very, very strongly that the lessons that we have learned from our investigations and in regard to what occurred here should be understood by people 100 years from now. But in order for people to understand 100 years from now to understand what has happened, it is very, very important for us to put into actual words.What we have learned.
報告の一番最後のところに委員長所管として次の7つのことを記しておきました。
As a result, at the end of the report, I have put in a section which is called basically the thoughts of the chairman, and I have listed 7 points that we should keep in mind.
残念ながら今配っている中には入っていません。
I'm sorry, as I mentioned earlier, although documents are being distributed to you, these are none of what I'm saying right now is included in the English translation.
はい、それでは順番に言っていきます。一つ目、あり得ることは起こる、ありえないと思うことすら起こる。
So the 7 points that I wanted to mention was, first of all, things that might possibly happen very much will.Happen, and even things that people think won't happen will actually happen.
よその国で起こっていることをきちんと学び、そして自分たちで準備をしておかなければいけないのに、日本では原子力安全委員会は1993年、ちょうどこれ起こる約20年前にですね、長時間にわたる 全電源喪失は考えなくてもよいということを明文化しました。
It is really the responsibility of people who are in charge of nuclear plants and other dangerous things to study very carefully what has happened in other nations and to learn from them and to make adequate preparations. In spite of this, however, in 1993, the Japanese Nuclear Safety Commission actually issued a statement saying that in Japan, we do not have to think about the possibility of a long-term power outage. They actually said that in an announcement.
私から見ると 日本の、工業製品の品質がすごくいいものになっているというふうに考える考え方で傲慢になっていたというふうに思います。
This goes back to what I was saying earlier, that as Japan grew economically and it developed very high-quality industrial products, I think there became a kind of complacency or kind of a kind of self-satisfaction among the Japanese that we won't suffer from the kinds of problems that other countries might.
2番目、見たくないものは見えない。見たいものが見える。
The second concept that I've listed here out of the seven is that things that you don't want to see, you probably will not see. And in fact, the things that you do want to see, you probably will see.
東京電力は自然災害の対策で津波に対する対策を整備しませんでした。
What I'm saying by this is that, as I mentioned earlier, TEPCO in its countermeasures, did not take any countermeasure policies regarding tsunamis.
また、複数の原子炉が同時に被災する。ということも考えていません。
Also, in their advanced planning, they never put together a scenario in which several reactors simultaneously would be experiencing difficulties.
私たちは自分の望まないことが望まない形で同時に起こるというようなことまできちんと考えなければいけないのに、全然考えませんでした。
I believe that, or we believe that there was a lack in preparation or in a lack in dealing, thinking about these very, very difficult issues. It's certainly human nature perhaps to want to not think about things that you don't want to happen. But you have to go even further and not only think about things that might possibly happen, but also think that terrible things will happen simultaneously.
3番目、すべては変わる。変化に柔軟に対応しなければならない。
The third point is that everything changes and there needs to be flexibility in responding to these changes.
福島県沖を震源とする大規模な地震や津波の可能性がきちんと科学的知見としてどんどんと増していたのに、政府も東京電力もこのことに注目しませんでした。
When we look back, we see that, especially in recent years, more and more scientific evidence was accumulating that there would be a possible huge earthquake and very large tsunami that occurred off the coast of Fukushima. In spite of the buildup of this information, neither the government nor TEPCO really took notice.
こういう地震や津波を扱っている人たちは、知識が増加するにつれて、正しくその指摘をしていました。しかし、それを聞こうとしなかったのです。
Not only was the scientific knowledge being amassed, but the people who were involved and were very well informed did raise their voices and say that there is a possibility that an earthquake and tsunami will occur. However, neither TEPCO nor the government really paid attention.
同じように、スリーマイルアイランドやチェルノブイリで起こったことから、獲得した知見がどんどんと生まれてきていたのに、日本ではそういうことは起こり得ないとして、きちんとした知見を取り入れることをやりませんでした。
In a similar way, more and more information was being amassed regarding Three Mile Island and the Chernobyl accident. In spite of this, however, there was this fundamental feeling in Japan among those parties concerned that something like that would never happen in Japan. As a result, there was not a concerted effort to try to understand and comprehend and study this new information.
人間は今言ったようなふうに考えを作っていくという性質をいつも持っています。それでは実際にはどういうふうに考えて行動していったらいいのかが次に、そのことについて次にお話しします。
Human beings, of course, always have the ability to develop new ways of thinking. As a result, I'd like now to explain what I think needs to be done in the future in order to develop better ways of thinking.
4番目です。可能な限りの想定と十分な準備をすることです。
This leads me to my fourth point, which is that as much as possible, one should try to think about different ideas and try to make as good preparations as possible.
地震の想定と備えは相当にやってありましたが、津波への想定は貧弱そのもので、 ほとんど備えがありませんでした。
In regard to earthquakes, there was a great deal of effort made to think about the possibility and to think about preparing for them. But in regard to tsunamis, there was almost very little done. The efforts that were directed toward tsunami preparation were very paltry.
予期しない事柄への十分な備えがしてあれば、今回のような大事故には至らなかったというふうに思います。
Looking back over our investigation, I think that if proper preparations had been done for things that were quite unexpected or fairly, you know, things that happen very rarely but still could possibly happen, if preparations had been made, we would not have had this very large accident.
5番目です。形を作っただけでは機能しない。仕組みは作れるが目的は共有されない。
The fifth point is that it's very, very easy to make a system or a mechanism or a scheme or an organization, but to be able to make it function, to be able to have everyone share common goals and understanding is a very different thing.
スピーディーというシステムを作っていたのに、放出源情報が得られないので、これを全く使えないものとして、避難の一番重要な時に避難する人たちに正確な情報を伝える努力が全くされませんでした。
As an example, I go back to the point about Speedy. Because the very important data about the source of the radiation emission, that kind of data was not included in Speedy at that time because many of the monitors or information gathering equipment was down. Because the information was incomplete, even though there was this very, very good system, because people did not have this understanding that they could make their own decisions and use that information, the data that was prepared by Speedy simply was not given out to the people who needed it most. In other words, to the people who were fleeing.
多額のお金をかけて立派なシステムを作っていたのに、一つ入力情報が欠けたら全く使えないものと信じてしまうような人たちがこれを運用していたのです。
I'm very critical of the fact that the people who were running the system, in spite of the fact that tremendous amounts of monies and investment had been made to create this very brilliant system, very good system, just because part of the data that needed to be input into the system was missing, the people operating said that we can't use any of the results of the system. That I find to be quite unfortunate.
最も大事なオフサイトセンターが機能しませんでした。
Another thing that we see did not go well was the fact that the off-site center, which should have been the most important place for people to operate from, did not function at all.
信じられないことですが、オフサイトセンターに放射線防護の設備が整備されていなかったのです。
I mean, the reality is almost incredible, very difficult to believe, but this off-site center, which was supposed to be used for emergencies, did not have radioactive protection.
お金がなかったからではありません。予算はきちんとついていたのに、これを作ることをやらなかっただけです。
I would like to point out it was not a problem of not having enough money. There was enough money budget allocated for this building. It's just that they didn't build in radioactive protection.
組織の構成員がその仕組みが何を目的とし、社会から何を予託されているのかを十分に自覚していなければ、全体としては初期の機能を果たせないのです。
What I'm saying is that in an organization, if the individual members of that organization do not have an understanding of the general picture, if they do not understand what the main goals of this organization is, if they do not understand what it is that the public and society expects of them, then they cannot act properly in an emergency situation.
6番目です。危険の存在を認め、危険に正対して議論ができる文化を作らなければなりません。
The sixth point is another thing that I think Japan must do in the future. They must be able to create people who are able to, first of all, recognize and admit that there are certain risks that exist, and they must be able to meet these risks head-on and debate, discuss such risks.
原子力はエネルギー密度が高く、非常に危険なものだというふうに私は思います。しかし、危ないものならいらないというような 短絡的な考え方で社会のみんなが反応することを恐れて安全神話というものを作っていきました。
When you look at nuclear energy, I personally believe that because its energy concentration is very, very high, it is a very, very dangerous form of energy. Having said that, however, I think it is a problem when people involved in nuclear energy take the opinion that if they were to admit that there is risk involved, that there is danger involved, the overwhelming reaction of society will be that, as I said earlier, we don't want it if it's dangerous. And as a result, they pretend that it is safe and create this safety myth. I think that is a very, very problematic response.
原子力の防災マニュアルでシビアアクシデントに対応するものはできていませんでした。そして事前の防災訓練も全く不十分でした。
When in regard to a severe accident occurring at a nuclear power plant, if you look at the disaster prevention manuals, there really is no preparation made for the possibility of a severe accident occurring. And as a result, there were really fundamentally no advanced training or drills that were implemented.
危険の存在を認めなければ、本当に必要になる防災とか減災の対策を取ることができなくなります。
It's obvious that unless, first of all, one recognizes, admits that there is a risk that exists, you cannot formulate effective preventive or countermeasures, preventive measures or countermeasures against such an event occurring.
私たちは利便と危険のバランスで考えることが求められています。
I believe what is requested of authorities of all people involved in such activities is that we have to find a good balance between danger and convenience.
危険そのものをきちんと議論できる文化を今から作っていかなければいけないと思います。
I therefore feel very, very strongly that we must now create a new kind of culture in which we can discuss and debate openly in a straightforward way.Dangers.
で、7番目、最後ですが、自分の目で見て、自分の頭で考え、判断、行動することが非常に重要です。
And the seventh point, and this is the last observation that I make, and about the new kind of people that we want to see nurtured in Japan, is that we want to create people who are able to look at things with their own eyes, who are able to think about things with their own minds, who are able to be discerning, make proper judgments on their own.
原子力発電所の現場ではこの通りのことを現場の運転員たちがやったのです。
I would like to also to point out that in regard to this Fukushima nuclear power plant accident, the people on site did respond in this way.
すべての電源がなくなって、すべてのメーターが読めなくなり、何の操作もできなくなったとき、現場にいた運転員たちは自分たちの自動車のバッテリーをかき集めて直流電源の代替としました。
When power was lost at the site and none of the meters could therefore be read, the people who were operating equipment at the site thought on their own and they went to their automobiles and they took out their car batteries and they connected it to the equipment providing direct current so that they could have some electricity.
必要な計器の読み取りがようやくできるようになって、内部の状態をわずかながら把握することができるようになったのです。
It is because of such creative and sincere efforts that they were able to operate some of the meters and gauges so that they were able to read some of the instruments. As a result, they were able to get at least a minimum amount of data about what was happening inside the reactors.
自分が死ぬことまでを覚悟して、やらなければならないことをきちんとやった運転員たちのおかげで、この事故は現在のようなところに収まっているんだというふうに思います。
As I said at the beginning, it is because of the activities of these people on site who basically risked their lives to deal with this situation. It is because of their efforts that this accident was limited in scope to its current state. In other words, it could have been much, much worse.
想定外の事故や災害に適切に対応するには、先ほど言ったように、個人が独立して考えて行動できるような能力を持ち、しかも能動的に 自分が考えるということをやらないと対応ができません。
I believe that when a situation occurs, when an external force creates an unexpected situation or an anticipated situation, what is important is to have individuals newly created who are able to be able to think independently on their own and who are able to take action on their own. They have to be able to be proactive, not simply reactive.
委員長として考えたのは今までにお話しした7つのことです。そしてこの事故はまだ終わったわけではなくて現在進行しているのです。
So these are the seven points that if I were to summarize all of my thoughts during this investigative process, these are the seven conclusions that I've come to as chairman of this committee. I would also like to point out that this accident, this situation has not finished. It is still an ongoing situation.
私たちの委員会が明らかにし考えた中身はここまでです。しかしこの働きはまだまだ他の組織なり国の組織なりいろいろなものを作って継続していかなければいけません。
In other words, these are the conclusions as has been presented in our final report. These are the conclusions of the committee. However, as I said, it is an ongoing situation. I believe it is very important that new organizations be established, whether under the auspices of the government or otherwise, to continue with these investigations.
やらなければいけないことはまだたくさんあります。私たちが明らかにしたことは全体の中のほんの一部の部分だというふうに思っています。
In other words, I believe there is still a massive amount of work that needs to be done. What we have done in our committee is only a tiny portion of the total amount of work.
はい、これで私の考えてきたことはおしまいです。
So this concludes some of the impressions and thoughts that I've had as the committee chairman.
Thank you very much, Professor Hatamura. And now I'm opening the floor to questions. Working press first, and please restrict yourself to one question at a time. And introduce yourself by name and affiliation first.
Edwin Carmel, freelance. So far, what actions have been taken against the people responsibleFor the maintenance of the nuclear plants and the safety measures. Thank you.
When you say actions, do you mean some kind of pen?そうですね、なんか処罰か何かはされているのでございましょうか。その責任者に対する処罰とかは、何かされてますのでしょうか。そしてまたそのどのような安全対策は新しく、安全対策などは新しく導入されてますので。